since I saw my first, you know, Sol in the Sky, 2011. And so here we are. We said we would knock on Downing Street until this gets resolved. So I'm really glad you've come to do this with us today. And, you know, like I said, a long journey. You know, we've been all over the world with this. We're connected all over the world. This is a global program. We are exposing it. And we've been to conferences with major activists, Max Bliss, Terry Lawton. Terry and Harry, as we speak, are flying to Vancouver to do a talk at the Chemtrail Summit, and they're going to be doing some great new information that he's giving out. And so we have a letter of intent now, because we didn't hear back from the Prime Minister two years ago, and so we're putting a little bit more pressure on now. You know, so when we get our evidence, we can really be a little bit more to the point with them now, because it has to stop. But meantime, we now have a new website that we would love you all to go to. It's called the Blue Sky Mandate. And we've used this because it is helping people come in at the ground level just to see what is happening in the sky. It's obscuring our sun, it's affecting our health. And so I hope you can all go there and help spread the word with your friends and family, where we're not mentioning the word chemtrails or geoengineering. And what we're going to do is a systematical approach to ask unanswered questions and anomalies, and slowly, you know, we're going to corner them and then knock it on the head. So do go there, Blue Sky Mandate, and work with that website. There's a new petition on there. So we're going to start from the ground up, and this way you can share with all your friends and family, just like, look at this, what's this, and let's find out now. So now we have the information, we know how to approach government, and we know how to talk about this with our officials. So in DC as we speak, we have Jolie Diane is going into Congress, and she's meeting with many officials as well. So we're working in a consistent manner with the government now to get this exposed and to get it stopped. So thank you all for coming. Enjoy your march, and we'll see you at number 10.
And you know, like, lots of names will come to my mind, like Max Bliss, the people that have done amazing work, Lorraine, who's just in front of us, just there, anyway. There's just so many people to mention that in the last few years, I can't, because there's just too many people that have made such a difference, because they sacrificed so much to get out there on the streets and make a difference.
And I'm just here to represent Fiji and Fijians and people of the South Pacific to show the world that we're like this small, tiny island on the other side of the globe, but we're awake. We are awake.
Nice.
You know?
Nice.
We know that they're trying to kill us.
Yeah,
they're trying to kill us, you know? Like this small, tiny island, why are they so jealous of us, you know? Just a tiny, tiny place. Fiji, the way the world should be, come on, you know? Yeah. It's not just Fiji, it's the whole world. It's Gaia, you know?
Yeah, well said.
I'm just so thankful that you guys are here, that we're all here for one reason and one reason alone, and that's to uphold the truth. To show the world that we're awake, you know? Yeah. We can see you through their guys. Thank you, everybody.
again, Anthony. Hello. This is a letter for the Director General. It's to put him on and the BBC on notification.
Okay.
That you are to, in the future, be prosecuted for the cover-up of the geoengineering.
Right, okay.
That's going on in our skies. Okay, so this is a notification. It's been signed by 21 UK citizens. It's an official document. And from here on in, we would like to ask you to start covering this topic seriously, informing the public what's going on, because currently you are not. And that is against your ethos. Okay, so you need to give biased, unbiased reporting on the subject. You know.
Okay,
thank you.
Yeah, that's fine. I can pass it on for you.
And we're handing a petition in to David Cameron today, 5,000 signatures.
Yeah.
And it's based on the directive to ban stratospheric aerosol geoengineering and aerosol spraying, which is happening in our size that you are subject to every day, your very own self. So, and another document there to back up information.
Okay. So that's going to Parliament, yeah?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
And what's your name again, please?
I'm Anthony.
Anthony what?
Bennett.
Anthony Bennett. Thanks. And what department do you work in, Anthony?
I'm the building manager here. So
you're the building manager.
Yeah. So I'll pass that on.
And you go and ask them to get the cameras and have a little story on this.
I'm afraid they won't be able to do that.
Okay.
Times pressing. Thank you very much for coming down.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you for your time.
All
goodbye.
Right.
Cheers. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
And in documentation this time round, landmark achievement, ladies and gentlemen. The notice is now being handed to David Campbell, so I'm sure when he turns up for his cup of coffee on Tuesday morning, he'll be opening that. Okay, thanks very much, guys.
Yeah.
Okay.